Hi everyone, Sean here. Gonna do this little video to explain a bit better my sharpening templates if you're a bit confused. What I used to make those gravers was a concrete nail. Just, you know, there's a theory that hobo nickels were carved with a nail, so I wanted to see if it was possible. So I just happened to find a pack of concrete nails, not very expensive, and they're pretty hard. These templates are designed to use something that's round, so any steel that is hard enough, if you get a metal file, and it is just biting, but it's kind of slipping off. So anything you can find, a drill bit or piano wire, you can buy a piano wire in different dimensions. It comes soft, but you can temper it if you like. Look on the internet to temper. I'd say the colour is yellow, according to what I read. So you could make something better than this. But these work pretty well because they're not that hard. When you first engrave, you will tend to twist the graver, and that's what will cause to snap the tip. So these being not that hard will actually probably help you as a beginner. Now the template, let me explain how to the previous video may have been a bit confusing. I rushed it a bit. So what you first do when you get your nail or your round object, be that shape, you need to create a flat on the back of it to locate it in your template. So you need to grind a flat area in the correct position. I'll fire as much information as I can, and you can rewind this tape, play it back again. And right, so you get your template, you know, you'll have to work out how to make those, the printable thing in the attached video. Just stick the paper on your material. You could use wood. This is chopping board, that's quite good, but thin wood would work. I've used steel, different things. So you cut around as accurately as you can. Get one of the templates. All right. So on the this is this actual. That's what I made from that, and it just tells you it's a 70 degree with a 10 degree heel, and you stick the graver out 30 mils. If you look at this, this is the most crucial, that little cross there. You want to get that as accurately as you can, but you know, maybe it won't be perfect. But so what I did in the video, you see me just make a tiny little center punch and then a bigger one. I think the video didn't come out. And the size of the drill, if I remember correctly, was a 5.5 mil. Also, these brass things come out of an electrical connector block we have in the UK, and incidentally it was a 15 amp, so that was the size. Also, once you've drilled the hole, you need to cut this section out here so that the back of it fits in. If you make it nice and snug, not this one, but most of them, you kind of just tap them in and they hold. But this one was slightly loose, so I put it in and super glued it in, so it held in place. So, right, so you've made your template, you've fitted your brass connector, and right, let's put that in there. So the correct setting to get that angle from this surface to the tip needs to be 30 millimeters. So you need to file that area or grind that area flat so that you'll, let's say for instance that's 30 mil, and you just put that screw down. I did notice, you know, these aren't perfect, but this is just to get you started. When it's not that difficult, the angles to sharpen, but when you start, it's kind of confusing and you're never quite sure if you're right. This cut holds quite well. If your material you're using is thinner, you might just want to check that's in the center and then tighten that down. But it works quite well. What you may have been confused with is, I'll try and show the best I can on the camera, is obviously this, when you're starting, your material is round. So the way I did it on there, I set it lower than the gravel was meant to be, just so I could create a flat area. So this is a diamond stone, let's say, right. So say that's the surface, so that's about 5 mil. So I just created a flat, went that way and went that way. But to actually do the point, you slide the template on the surface of whatever you're using. So whatever stone you're going to use, you could use some emery paper on a flat surface and do that. So that's to create the final angle. You'll go that way a few times and that way a few times, and to create the face you just turn it up. And you might experiment, obviously if you change the distance, then you will change the angles and you may find that you like a different angle. Once your grave is sharp, a simple test just to make sure it is sharp, and something you should do while you're engraving, is touch it to the back of your fingernail and you'll feel it stick. If you're slipping while you're engraving, then just do that and you'll be checking whether it's sharp. So something you need to do now and again. You see the back of my fingernails all stabbed because every now and again. But these are surprising, they last quite well. What I would say is try to get them as sharp as you possibly can. What I use for a final step, this is a Lansky, is a knife sharpening device, and this is the Lansky sapphire stone, about £11, not very expensive. I do charge it with 0.25 micron diamond paste, but doesn't really need it, but I can't help myself. If you're using, you could also use chrome polish. Any chrome polish will work like a 50,000 grit, what's that, half micron diamond paste, but it won't do carbide. It's just any other steel, high speed steel, it will polish. So right, so final stages, we've got our graver nice and polished. You could probably go to, if you're using emery paper, 2000 grit emery paper. So it's nice and polished, we've tested it, it's sharp. Now you'll see a video coming up of me carving there's a video of me coming up carving this skull. I thought that was a good subject to carve, quite popular skulls. And all I've used is a flat graver using my template and the 70 degree graver. Let me explain. A technique I discovered, if you hammer and chisel, you must much less likely to slip with the graver, and holding the male graver like that, you can tap. You can tap slow or you can tap fast, and I'll do it on this bit here. you can really move some metal. I'll zoom in and I'll show you. I'll do a little bit of the braid. So all I'm using, this is a, it's just some copper tube. I've tried different things. I've got a, that's a guitar slide, but it doesn't, my finger's a bit fat for it, but maybe you can get these in different sizes. And that's you only need a few ounces to tap your graver, and that's plenty. In an air graver, it has a piston, and it probably weighs about 20 grams. That's what you're doing. And that's enough. It's surprising. I'm still experimenting with it. I use an air graver normally, but I'm just trying to help people start. You know, you can really get metal moving. It's surprising. Let's do this bit. Right, let's see that. Let's zoom back in. Trying to do this on the camera at the same time as. Okay, I've set it up in my engraver's vise now, so it's a bit easier to film. Let me show you using the technique of the. I'm not hitting the back of the nail hard at all. It does the tool, it's nice and sharp, it does all the work, and you know, if you was trying to push that amount of metal out, I'd say you're almost guaranteed to slip, or it wouldn't be possible. And I don't want to. And I'll show you the flat. This is using the flat graver. What should we do? Again, if you get your graver nice and polished, it will leave the surface the same, the equivalent polish. When you cut that, that's pushing, and you can when you've removed as much material, you can just hold it in your hand. You don't have to apply a lot of force, just go gently. It tidy up the areas. Now, the most useful thing I've found, I've got another video describing the Hisagi scraper. It's made from an old file, that's good still, and there's the shape of it. So imagine a kind of a butter knife, and it's sharpened square. So, and again, if you look at the sides, they're nice and polished. That's the critical thing. And you can also test it, just kind of every now and again. When I start using it, I get my sapphire stone . Give it a few swipes. And that just polishes that side. You see it's shiny. Maybe the side as well every now and again. And it's amazing. I mean, you can you can't really see it on the video as much, but as I cut, it leaves the surface like a mirror, like it's shiny, and you can really get in and just go, just take your time. You don't have to force. If it's nice and sharp, it'll do all the work for you. You can also use it, for instance, this part of the skull. You've used your 70 degree and you've cleaned it up. It's got a square edge. Most things you're going to be carving, they want to be rounded. So you can just use that. If you examine pictures of skulls, if that's what you want to do, this part is kind of rounded. This part is lower than this part, so you can use that. Use the scraper. That. Same here. Right, next thing you'll see is the video of this start to finish. Thanks.